From Baldwin Creek Elementary, this is the Bobcat News with your anchors, Grace Kemp and Sawyer Norton. Where every Bobcat matters every day.
Hello, Bobcats.
Welcome. Today is National Opposite Day. This week's trivia question is, what is the opposite of good day in German? A. Guten Nacht, B. Cheerio, C. Guten Hund, or D. Sayonara.
The school spelling bee took place on Wednesday. Katie Anderson took first place, Kaylin Brinkman was second, and Shanti Junker was the alternate. Kennedy talked with our winners.
I'm here with the school spelling bee winners. Are you looking forward to being alternate?
I'm excited to attend.
What is the hardest word you have spelled, Shanti?
Probably wafer.
What is the hardest word you have spelled?
Fulcrum.
Conservatory.
Do you have any spelling tricks or tips?
Like, before I spell the word out loud, I like picture what I'm going to say in my head.
How long did you study?
I was studying since the beginning of January every night before I went to bed.
Did someone help you study?
Yeah, my dad told me the words and I spelled them.
Did someone help you study, Kevin?
No.
Yeah.
Thank you.
If it seems too cold outside and you want to stay inside, the Bobcat News team has some suggestions. We tried to come up with some ideas that involve unplugging from electronics.
So something that you can do, you can read a book, you can read a magazine, and you can always cuddle up with a blanket and relax.
If you have a brother or sister, you can play board games, and if you don't have a brother or sister, you can invite friends over or play with your parents.
Another thing you could do when it's cold outside is you can make hot chocolate, and then you could always bake cookies or cupcakes or something and invite your friends over.
A good way to spend a snowy day inside is doing a puzzle. Here we got a good puzzle. Just find one and maybe you can redo it. So have fun.
When it's a cold day outside and I don't really have anything to do, I usually like to knit. You can knit something like this, and you don't even have to have knitting needles. You can use pencils.
One way to have fun if you don't want to go outside in the winter is playing the Wii. It's an electronic device, but you're moving, and so it's really fun. We have some dance moves.
Next week, all the fifth grade classes will participate in snowshoeing and science. Kaylin is interviewing Mrs. Hitchcock to get some details.
I'm here with Mrs. Hitchcock to talk about the field trip when we go snowshoeing. What are we going to learn when we go snowshoeing?
When we go snowshoeing, we're going to learn how to snowshoe, and we're also going to learn a lot of different scientific concepts. So depending on the day you go, you might be learning about decomposers and life cycles. You might be learning about matter and its interactions. You might be learning about perhaps shadows and sunlight, and perhaps watershed and ecosystems and north slope versus south facing slope. There'll be all sorts of learning to do in the outdoors that day.
How should we dress?
Layers, layers, layers. Definitely dress in layers, because the day could be really, really cold, or the sun could come out and really warm things up. So make sure that you have hats, gloves, boots, coats, and snow pants. And then if you can dress in layers, like a short sleeve shirt and then a long sleeve shirt underneath your coat, that would be fantastic.
Is this activity part of a grant?
The activity itself is not a part of a grant. However, Jamie Simonson, who's the superintendent up at Sinks Canyon State Park, did use a grant to secure snowshoes for all of us. So last year, he purchased 40 pairs of brand new snowshoes for our use. So, yay!
Could we bring our own snowshoes if we have them?
If you have your own snowshoes, you may bring them, but if you don't, no worries, because Mr. Simonson has a bunch.
Is there anything I didn't mention that you would like to add?
Just come prepared for a great day of learning with lots of layers, a lunch, and a positive attitude.
Now it's time to check in with Erica and Jacob for the sports for this week.
Hi, Bobcats.
Hi, Bobcats.
The hockey team has a tournament this week in Riverton.
There are two swim meets. One is in Moreland and the other is in Green River. Good luck, swimmers.
Dancers are hard at work in the studio. Keep on dancing.
There is a traveling basketball team going on. There was a game on Tuesday. They beat St. Stephen's and played Wind River on Thursday.
There was a climbing competition in Lander last week. Shanti Junker took first place, Anna Taglioli placed second, and Nathan Leaf Green was third. Twyla Beeson also competed.
Diving is going on. If you're interested, talk to Sawyer Norton or Carter Playstead.
Today for the sports joke, what kind of stories do basketball players tell?
What?
Tall tales.
Bye, Bobcats.
See you next week.
Let's see what Paxson has for the weather next week.
Hola, Bobcats. This week I am going to visit some amazing monuments as I report the weather. I am at the Eiffel Tower. On Monday, January 28th, there will be AM showers with a high of 21 and a low of 2. There will be a 40% chance of precipitation. Now I am at the Great Sphinx of Giza. On Tuesday, January 29th, it will be mostly sunny with a high of 28 and a low of 14. There will be a 0% chance of precipitation. Now I am at Mount Rushmore. On Wednesday, January 30th, it will be mostly cloudy with a high of 30 and a low of 14. There will be a 0% chance of precipitation. Now I am at the Statue of Liberty. On Thursday, January 31st, it will be partly cloudy with a high of 29 and a low of 14. There will be a 10% chance of precipitation. Now I am at the Great Wall of China. On Friday, February 1st, it will be cloudy with a high of 30 and a low of 14. There will be a 30% chance of precipitation. Make sure to wear appropriate clothing. Adios, Bobcats.
Now for this week's reminders. Chess Club will meet on Tuesday right after school in the library. Remind your parents that Chess Club ends at 4.
All fifth grade classes will be snowshoeing next week. Make sure you know which day your class will be going and make sure you are prepared for your day for the day with appropriate clothing and a lunch.
The student council is hosting a movie night tonight in the gym. The movie will be Ferdinand.
Candy grams are now on sale. Talk to your class representative to order candy gram before Valentine's Day.
Keep reading to reach those AR goals and keep walking to earn those blazing Bobcat miles.
Now for that trivia question. If you guessed A, gluten knocked, you are correct. See you next time on the Bobcat News.
Adios, Bobcats.